Welcome to the hydraulic press channel. Today we have really interesting video. We are going to test which is stronger, aluminium rim or steel rim. And the idea is pretty simple. We are going to just put the rim and the tire in the press, and then we will crush them and see how much of pressure it takes. And then we can calculate the force that we needed to crush the rims. And this video is done in collaboration with Valtavalo. They gave new LED tubes for our workshop, and I also have cupolas and filming lights. They should be really good filming lights because they have good color rendering index and they don't flicker at all. If you want to learn more about the lights, I have video on Beyond the Press channel where we change the lights to our workshop and do some tests with high speed camera and the lights, and they really don't flicker at all on any frame rates. And we are also going to use our Kronos 1.4 high speed camera today. And I really like my new setup where the lights are attached to the blast screen. They give really soft light because they are so large compared to my old spotlights. So nice to see how the picture is going to look today. Yeah, but let's start with the aluminium rim. I think this is going to be harder than the steel rim, but let's find out. And this is really dangerous, don't ever try anything like this at home. And here we go! Oh. Yeah, it broke from the back and on the front, so I think that's finished. And I don't know what was the peak pressure, but it was this amount of force. I see it on the edit. Yep, and I don't know how strong it was, but I think it wasn't like stupidly strong. And I'm a bit disappointed that it first broke on the back, but I have more of these, so I'm going to switch new one there, and then we are going to crush it again, so you can see how it breaks from the behind. But let's check the damage from this one, and I think we are going to use this one as an like reference on the force. So here is the end result. It's pretty broken. And I didn't have a lot of air here because it was really hard to fit inside of the press. But I think this is like some serious pothole if you end up rim like this, so I think they are strong enough probably. Yeah, but one more of these. Yep, and let's have a look on the damage with this one. We have a flat tire, here is hole, and I think the damage is pretty similar with both of these. Yeah, but now we know how strong these are. And then let's try with the steel rims. Yep, and now we have steel rims there. This is actually summer tire from our YouTube car. If you want to see that on action, There is also a lot of stuff on Beyond the Press channel about that. But the car is not going to see the next summer, so we can crush the summer tires. Yeah, I think that's ready. Yep, so let's have a look on the damage. And I don't know, but you know now which one was stronger. And it's also stole our safety strap. It's there and it's not coming out. But I think it was in pretty good condition anyways. And on the behind, yeah, and just as I expected, the steel rims, they stay in one piece. They don't shatter at all. So even if the aluminium one was maybe stronger, I think these can take like pretty bad hit. And that's going to end up in dent, while the aluminium rims can take maybe slightly more, but they will like break in one go. But we have one more test to do with the rims, because I have still many of these, so why not crush more? So I'm going to raise the table and then we are going to continue. Yep, and this is my own very special side impact test for the rims. This simulates the situation where you drift against the like curbstone or something like that. And yeah, let's see which one is better. And here we go.
Whoa! Woo!
That was pretty good. I have no idea how much was their force, but at least there was sound. We have some stuff here, and I have to say that I didn't expect it to be so violent. And
wow!
I think this was the main problem when we lost this. This was like here, or like just like this here. And when this came loose, all the air escaped from here and it threw the tire up against the roof of the press. And I think I should have my high speed camera running maybe a little bit faster. It was so big bang. Yeah, that was really cool. Way better than the first ones. And here we go. Yep. And let's see if we have any air. No, it's empty. Yep, and let's have a look. I think we mainly just changed the offset of the tire. It's going to be now much more out from the car. And there's also somewhere small hole on the rim. There wasn't any big explosions and the tire still seems to be attached pretty well. Yeah, but we have still a couple of these and one aluminium rim and tire left, and we are going to explode these with my 300 bar air compressor on Beyond the Press channel. So now it's good time to go check the LED tube video out and subscribe the channel at the same time. And big thanks for Valtavalo, the G4 LED tubes are really good for filming and there wasn't any problem with flickering or anything today. Yeah, but that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have this Cope Fair. I have no idea what it's going to do. We don't have those in Finland, but looks to be some kind of rat or mole, so probably pretty evil and dangerous animal. So we have to deal with it.